Hi, I am Inez Barbario, and welcome back to a very special edition of Core Growth Strategies, Positivity and Success Stories. Breaking the barriers of a struggling performer, my next guest, with her amazing talent and positive energy, led her to an opportunity of a lifetime with Idina Menzel. I am thrilled to have singer Beta Spindola as my guest today. Good morning. Hi, Beta. So nice to virtually meet you today.
Nice to virtually meet you.
And as we were discussing a little bit prior, when I saw you on Undercover Boss Celebrity Edition with Idina Menzel, I knew right away that you needed to be on my show. And I want you to just share this beautiful like experience and this voice of yours, if you're willing to sing a little bit.
Oh gosh.
Put you on the spot. And just your energy. I want my viewers to know that when I saw you on the show, what attracted me most about you was just this beautiful, positive energy. And the way that, you know, they have to go watch the show, because when you were on the show with Idina, not knowing who she was, how warm and caring and patient you were with her, and you know, her character, which was, you know, kind of like, you know, not a little bit frumpy.
Humbled as a handful. We loved her.
Yeah. But you just like, you were just there. You were just so nurturing. So tell us about the whole experience, how you got on the show, everything about it.
Yeah. Things folks won't typically know is I wasn't doing well performance wise prior to getting the show. I'd worked on a cruise line before then. Mm-hmm. But I guess for whatever reason and the powers that be, I didn't get asked to come back for the following contract. Mm-hmm. Which later they would ask me back again, but just for the time being, I didn't know what I was going to do. I had quit my job to like pursue performing full time. Mm-hmm. Bills were starting to pile up. I had a surgery that I was paying off. And I was just struggling. So I was taking any gig I could get, and there was just audition after audition, and everyone's just saying, we think you're great, but you don't fit the part. Mm-hmm. So it's a lot of almost yeses. Yeah. Eventually I'm doing this gig at, just this joint in West Hollywood, and this woman comes in and she said, and of all the songs I'd be singing, it'd be Let It Go.
Naturally.
All the songs. Yeah. And this woman comes in and she asks in the middle of my set, would you like to be part of the show about singers trying to make it?
Mm-hmm. Yes, of course. Of course. I'm trying to be part of this.
Mm-hmm. And it had been just like a roller coaster ever since. It had gone like way off. It just what happened so fast. And next thing you know, I'm on set, or I'm on this, or in this huge like wedding hall, because I was singing for wedding gigs at the time, trying to, you know, make ends meet.
Okay.
And then in comes Helen, and then you see the show. And
okay, so for people who don't know, Helen was played by Idina Menzel, who was in total costume at the time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she was undercover. She was the celebrity undercover. Mm-hmm. And her character, Helen, was trying to figure out like if the performing world is for her. And she was shadowing me for the day. And like, this is what I do. It is also a struggle, but it's worth it if you really mm-hmm. want it.
Yeah.
It's an absolute struggle. We got through it. And I told her a bit about my life and how my dream was to move to New York, and I just want to sing, but I'm struggling financially and all the fun stuff. And
where were you living at the time?
I was living with my parents. I was living in my parents' house in Southern California.
Oh, okay.
And my parents are first generation American, so they worked ground up and they built a life for themselves that I'm really proud of.
Good for you.
And they've shown me an example of what hard work can do. And sometimes a little bit of help is needed in the hard work. And mm-hmm. here we are.
Yeah. Now, when you saw when Idina uncovered herself, you started crying.
Oh, it was a mess. It was a sobbing mess.
Tell me, do your best to put those emotions and feelings into words.
Just the culmination of everything that I've been going through, like all the work, all the rejection, mm-hmm. and my high school idol. Like when I tell you I burned a hole into that Wicked CD, I am not kidding you. Like I was obsessed with her. She's just, I don't know. I really looked up to her and just her sound and what she did. And then for it to be her up there was surreal in a way. Yeah. It Yeah, I don't know. It was just really nice to sit there and like be completely taken aback by emotion and just this woman that I've looked up to almost my entire life to be right there in front of me, like nothing. So casual.
I mean, it's amazing how the universe works. I mean, you basically like manifested her into your life.
Basically.
For all these years. And yet, and also like in your profession, it's a lot of rejection.
Oh, absolutely.
And yet you keep a smile on your face. How do you get through that?
I just have a lot of faith, to be honest with you. Like I have to have faith that things are going to work out because they have in the past. Mm-hmm. This is the biggest example. I remember just sitting in my brother's car sobbing. Yeah. I needed to borrow $50 to pay an overdraft fee because I was just struggling. Because my savings had ran out. And like, it's not that I didn't prepare for the rainy days. The rainy days just lasted a little longer than I expected. And I'm just sitting in the front seat of his car crying out and just asking like, God, if you want this for me, make it obnoxiously clear. If you want another path for me, then make that clear too. And so I didn't get any more obnoxiously clear than Adina Menzel going, here, all your dreams come true. I think so, those aren't supposed to be.
So she helped you. I mean, she helped you get an apartment in the city.
Yeah, she did.
She helped you with some finances.
And not only that, but she invited me to sing with her at the PlayStation Theater for her nonprofit organization. Words are hard today. The Broader Way Foundation. And it helps girls who don't normally get another chance to be exposed to the arts have a chance at this camp to work with like some amazing people, get exposed to music and see if this is something that, you know, they really want to do.
That's fantastic because, you know, the unfortunately music and the arts programs really are getting cut in schools and public schools.
Left and right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's the first thing to go, which is a shame because, you know, part of education is being innovative and showing your talents and opening. It's not all academics. And this is coming from an academic person. I have a very academic background, but I'll be the first to tell you that, you know, to be successful in life and to be a good person and to be just have a great foundation is not solely academics.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I have heard recently that a lot of business students are recommended to take at least one art class because you learn in a master class basically what it is to brand yourself, to market yourself. Like no one knows business more than artists, in my opinion.
Exactly.
Because it is also a business where I mean it's the love and the passion. Absolutely. We love art. Art keeps us going through like some of our darkest days.
Yeah.
But we also gotta pay bills. So we have to learn how to do that as well as achieve some dreams. So clearly I'm a fan.
So what have you been doing in New York?
I've been auditioning, I've been performing at small gigs here and there, just meeting some amazing people. Like you have to be in the city. I've actually just recently got involved with the Broadway Dreams Foundation.
Which is?
It is a foundation that helps people, not just kids, but a lot of like grown adults like myself, get connected to the next step in their Broadway career. And a lot of the people that you see on Broadway have started out learning from Broadway Dreams Foundation.
Oh, wow.
People that are involved in it would be like Alex Newell from Once on This Island. Quentin Earl Darrington also from Once on This Island. Ryan Redmond, she was in If Then with Idina Menzel. Just countless others that have worked with the foundation to not only just help other students, but just they network and they meet other like artists. And it's just such a good community and family. Words are hard this morning. We just haven't had coffee. And I'm really proud of the work that they're doing there. And, I really do believe in the growth of that and in the individual artists. Like I truly believe that almost everyone I see go in through that program, if they decide to, will go to Broadway.
Oh, it's fantastic.
It's incredible. The talent. It's kind of rude.
Like, have you been going to Broadway shows?
Yeah, oh, absolutely. I can't live in the best city in the world and not go to Broadway shows. Gosh, I've just been crying left and right just because it's beautiful. Like I saw American Sun, I saw Head Over Heels, and just I'm sobbing at everything.
Have you seen Aladdin yet?
Of course I've seen Aladdin. My good friend Jacob Gutierrez went in as Aladdin for Telly, and he was incredible.
Oh, my friend Augie is a trumpet player in the orchestra.
Oh, no way. That's amazing. Yep. Oh, my goodness. Who was the swing for Phantom of the Opera on Broadway.
Wow.
I went to go see him and he took me backstage and it's so tight back there. And
right.
It's amazing. Oh my gosh.
That's what amazed me. How teeny tiny is backstage?
That's New York. That is New York for you. We make magic from tiny spaces.
It must be so beautiful right now with Christmas in New York.
Oh my gosh, this is my first Christmas season in New York, and it's electric here. There's no other city like this.
Mm-hmm. So what are your goals then? I mean, I know it's got to be in Broadway somewhere, I'm thinking.
I kind of just want the Idina Menzel career. She's got it all. She's done Broadway. She's done film. She's got her own albums. She can tour. She can have a life and a child and a family. Like, I want all that. I want to have it all.
And you can, you know.
Why not?
Why not? Live the dream, be the dream.
Absolutely.
What advice do you have for, you know, for young kids that are like looking to get into this career?
Keep the faith.
Mm-hmm.
Believe in yourself. You have to be your biggest fan. Mm. On top of that, you need a support system. I'm so, so fortunate to have it be in my own family. Sometimes support system isn't in your family. So you go out and you find your theater family or someone. We are a good tight-knit community and family. So just find your support system, believe in yourself, and find those that do believe in you as well. It really does make all the difference.
It does. And I'm really glad that you said believe in yourself, because I think a lot of where people slack is their lack of belief in themselves. They're looking for external, you know, gratification and other people to tell them they can do it. You have to know within that you can do it.
At the end of the day, it's going to be you performing. So you can't have someone push you on stage and go, okay.
Here you go.
you've got to take the chance yourself. You've got to learn the material yourself. You have to be prepared. You show up. Mm-hmm. You have to show up. It is a marathon. It's not a race.
Right.
You just have to get to the finish line.
Absolutely. And I'm glad you said that. I mean, it's true. And it's a race against yourself, which is what we need to remember. Because especially in your field, I think a lot of people are feeling that they're competing against everyone else.
There's room for everyone at the top.
Mm-hmm.
You're the only you. You're not competing with anyone else other than who you were yesterday. I know it's cliche, but it really is true.
It is. And, you know, each one of us have our own special something, you know, and that's what makes us beautiful, is that uniqueness within us.
We're a talent potluck. You bring your own dish.
I like that. Great analogy.
We'll keep it.
All right. Are you comfortable singing a little something?
Oh, gosh. What would I even have? I'm singing something tonight, actually, at an art exhibition for the 36-24-36 project, which I'm very proud of.
Okay.
And it's a group of women who are trying to destigmatize the standard of beauty.
Mm-hmm.
And the song that we picked was Shallow from the recent A Star Is Born movie.
Okay.
Yeah, so let's see. Oh, gosh. I'll just start from the second verse.
Okay, no problem.
Tell me something, boy. Aren't you tired trying to fill that void? Or do you need more? Is there something else you're searching for? I'm falling. In all the good times, I find myself longing for change. And in the bad times, I fear myself. I'm off the deep end, watch as I dive in. I'll never meet the ground. Crash through the surface where they can't hurt us. We're far from the shallow now. In the shallow. In the shallow. In the shallow, far from the shallow now.
Oh my God. I think I'm gonna, I got tears in my eyes.
Oh, yay.
That is, incredible. I see really, really great things in your future, and I'm so excited to have met you.
We're working on it. We'll get there.
Oh my goodness. The audience is going to be blown away when they hear you.
Thank you so much. Aww. Thank you for this. This is lovely. It's nice to like share a story.
That's
what we do here on Broadway. We share stories.
That's right. So, you know, is there anything else that you want to add?
Just, I'm grateful for everything. I really am. Just overall, everything that's been thrown my way, I'm extremely grateful. And I hope whoever's watching this finds what they needed from it today, find a little bit of joy in it today.
know that you're exactly where you're supposed to be. And I'm proud of you. You're making your way.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful. Well, thank you so much for joining me. And I'm sure I'll be seeing plenty more of you soon.
I can't wait to see you soon.
All right, take care.
Thank you. All right.